Welcome to The Vibe, featuring the latest trends in arts and culture every day, Monday through Friday. The symbiotic relationship between painting and poetry in Chinese art is one that spans centuries. In a way, poems are paintings without form, and paintings are poems that inspire through form. It's what piqued Chinese ink and wash painting master Wang Mingming's interest, and one that has produced seamless unions of the two media in his latest exhibition, A Mood Beyond Poetry. In this episode of our Meet the Master series, we check out Wang's prolific career spanning five decades that has given rise to his unique style and interpretation of tradition.
父母横斜千万朵，赏心只有三两只。就说艺术创作要升华，要取舍，既要有传统与传承，又要有笔墨当时时代的创新。中国人也在努力地扬为中用，学他的技法来表现中国人的感情，讲中国故事。
我画的苏翊鸣漫画的，它就是夺金的时刻。我还画了谷爱凌凌空一跃漫。你要从历史的长河里边去确定的话，你就会有信心。我认识到中国的艺术，你必须得按中国的。
For ink and wash painter Wang Mingming, painting is not just about artistic expression. It's also about exploring the potential of traditional Chinese painting and finding inspiration from the rich culture it comes from. Under his brush, the works of famous ancient Chinese poets are represented on paper like never before. Wang's exquisite depiction expresses the charm of classic literature, and he's been implementing his unique philosophy through many of his themed exhibitions.
我的几个画展呢都是有专题的，你比如说，06年我做了一个花鸟画展，10年的时候做了一个书法展，12年的时候，在我60岁的时候，我做了一个儿童时期的画展。我当时的前言是写，我是。 在寻找失去的东西，因为儿童时期，很多的小画家或者小神童非常多，用他独特的眼光去看这个世界的时候，他是非常的单纯的。经历了这么长时间艺术生涯，我在审视自己的时候，那我就觉得你丢掉了什么？我觉得往往丢掉了自己内心的最纯洁的一些东西，那就是被 表象的技法所左右。你比如说，我画一个场店的糖葫芦，抓住了一些要想表现的那个本质的东西。可是你现在让我去，有可能没有那个时候画得好。Born
in 1952 in Beijing, Wang Mingming demonstrated an incredible talent for painting at an early age, and his father has played an important role in his artistic journey, taking Wang to visit painting masters in the city, including Li Kuchan, Wu Zuoren, and Jiang Zhaohe. These masters were all very fond of the little painter. They offered instructions and helped him lay a solid foundation. At just 6 years old, Wang won a major international award with a painting that, although may seem simple at first glance, is actually full of innovative strokes. And his name as a child prodigy gradually spread out across the city's art scene. Even today, Wang still recalls his experience of painting and selling these works at Beijing's Wang Fujing, along with a number of veteran painters.
那很多老画家就说，那让小画家也画一张吧。后来我当时画了一张桂鱼，上头拴着一个绳儿。 哎，大家都很高兴，说大画家卖多少钱，小画家也卖多少钱。
哇，还有这样的
东西。后来还让另外一个画家买走。这个时候呢，李苦禅先生就过来，他也非常喜欢我，跟我父亲说：“你有时间带孩子到我家来，我给他看看画。”就这样，完了我们就去了。今天我也带来了两个非常珍贵的小的陶瓷，一个公鸡，一个小马。这是苦老师第一次见到我的时候，临走的时候他送的，所以都一直在珍藏着这个。苦禅先生给我做了很多刻图稿，他有一段他说我示范给明明看，是要增加他的胆魄，不以其技法限其本能。他就是说我的技法不要限制你的心性。我觉得他作为一个教育家，他就告诉我这孩子，你不要临摹我，可是你要发挥自己的一样。
With such a bright future ahead of him, Wang's art career took an abrupt turn at the age of 17. In 1969, he got assigned to a tractor factory in Beijing and became a milling machine operator. Instead of a paintbrush, he was now holding a milling tool.However, Wang didn't let this constant hard work routine get in the way of his passion. He would squeeze every spare minute he had to hone his painting skills, sketching all over the place. There were times when he was still shaking from the laborious work he would do at the factory, and would draw the rough outlines, waiting until he's recovered a bit to work on the fine details of the painting. Even in difficult times like this,Wang never gave up on painting. He always stayed optimistic and focused on elevating his skills.
在工厂里我一待了十年，虽然条件非常的艰苦，那个时候呢，业余的时间那就到周边的郊区就去画速写。我觉得十年时间，我总结起来，我完成了绘画中的重要的转型，就是对造型的训练，对创作的基本的规律把握。77年高考，中央美院没有招生，那我就考的工艺美院。可是他给我的这个系呢是特异系，不是我想进的专业。我就跟周思聪老师商量，我说我不想去。后来他说那你就调画院来吧，我给你申请。后来。我就下定决心不去了。
With the help from his teacher Zhou Sicong, Wang Mingming got admitted to the Beijing Fine Art Academy as a special recruit. At his inauguration, the academy gathered painting masters like Qi Baishi, Chen Banding, and Wang Xuetao. Wang's teacher, Zhou Sicong, was also known for her ink and wash portrait painting. She hoped Wang could merge right in the creative soil of the academy and get all the nutrients he needed. And Wang spared no time in learning from the best, absorbing many different genres, including portraits, landscape, painting of birds and flowers, and even calligraphy. While incorporating diverse genres and techniques,Wang once found himself lost in the process, striving hard to find his own style. How could he paint like his predecessors at the Beijing Fine Art Academy? Freely, but with a signature style that is recognizable to all. Wang started exploring.
就是说，你自己感到很迷茫，就是不知道往哪条路上走，如何跟老师拉开距离。不是背叛老师，我说艺术就要有自己的主见，因为这几个老师包括周松卢神是我在艺术创作起重要作用的老师。可是那个时候我在画现实题材的时候就跟他们就靠得很近，所以这个时候我在就决定我要从题材拉开，就是画古代题材，慢慢的去进入到一个传统绘画之中。这个时候我觉得这个中华传统文化的源头是个活水。70年代末 姚铎先生指导我的写生的时候，他说你一定要学习点传统。后来我说怎么学习呢？因为当时资料很少，我就看了一本黄宾虹的画册，我觉得他的线条的组合和各个方面都非常好。后来看了一些，临了一点，我就画一些肖像画。姚铎看到以后，他说：“哎，你这个笔道跟原先不一样，你是不是学了什么？”我说：“我学了黄宾虹。”啊，他说：“你看看吧，这个传统嘛，有些东西你吸收了就是不一样。”
Wang's teacher Zhou Sicong once made this comment on Wang Mingming: "A young and promising painter, but not frivolous. He never seeks to be a maverick intentionally, but he keeps exploring new paths.And is always confident at heart." In 1980, Wang created a figure painting of Chinese poet Du Fu, inspired by his famous poem Spring View. In it, he stick to traditional strokes to portray the poet, while adding characters and historic figures mentioned in the poem in the background, giving the painting a touch of film montage.He found a way to recreate the poetic images with ink wash. A year later, Wang eyed for another great poet in ancient China, Qu Yuan. He went to the poet's hometown for inspiration and delivered another compelling ink wash painting. By placing the poet's figure in a misty environment, he keeps exploring the infinite possibilities of the ink wash medium.During this process, he has found his own style, which is creating a modern context for traditional culture, making the ancient relevant with today's world.
那个时候的确是对中国画的这个冲击非常大，基本上否定了中国画的方法。这个时候大家很迷茫，哎，不知道是学习西方好还是学习传统好。我83年去了一次法国。去了10天，我看到了很多的博物馆的画，当时也非常震撼。可是我回来以后，很多朋友问我，你觉得法国怎么样？我说太棒了，我看从来没有，因为第一次出国嘛，没有看到那么多西方的绘画。他说你变不变？那个时候呢，我也没改变。
你要从历史的长河里边去确定的话，你就会有信心。我认识到中国的艺术，你必须得按中国的来走。
Compared to the more realistic Western oil paintings, traditional Chinese painting is more about conveying the abstract vibe than shaping reality. It leaves great space for viewers to ponder on the cultural connotations beyond the work. And this requires the painters to have extensive knowledge on history and culture.From the 1980s, Wang has been leaving his footprints on famous mountains and rivers across the country. He's implementing the Chinese saying, read as many as 10,000 books and travel as far as 10,000 miles. And he poured what he saw and experienced in his paintings. In 1988, he created his very first hand scroll, Su Dongpo's Night Trip.And his techniques and styles matured in his later work, Su Dongpo, Memories of the Past at Red Cliff. Since 2006, Wang began envisaging to create a selection of paintings, drawing inspiration from old poems, combining figurative and semi-abstract strokes to recreate poetic images. They are in the form of an album,A structure in Chinese painting that gives viewers a feeling of intimacy as they turn each page.
这一批画呢，是我13年一个积累。细想，我真正在画院画画，做专业画家只有10年时间。很多朋友问我说：“你工作那么忙，可是你画的画是静的。”我说：“我做人，我干工作，是。”入世的，可是我说我画出来的作品让人静下来是出世的，所以在我的艺术生涯中，真正的画画的时间非常少，实际上很多都在一种业余状态。 06到07年画了一些，画了20张，后来就放下了。15年以后我才打开，再去看，我说那就可以陆续就画，多一半呢，那是我离开这个岗位，2017年、2018年到2019年把它完成。很多人问你干嘛不用最短的时间画出来，其实完全可以，你要做好计划可以画出来。可是我觉得这么多年我的一个收获是什么，因为你读诗去画这个一张一张的诗意，它实际上它是一个学习的过程，它是一个理解的过程。所以中国画难就难在我的体会，就是你慢慢的一个时期它所悟到的东西都不一样，它有一个时间的过程和一个酿酒一样的一个转化过程。
In June 2022, Wang Mingming's solo exhibition, A Mood Beyond Poetry, opened at the Beijing Fine Art Academy. With over 100 paintings from his works spanning from 2006 to 2019 on display. From the child prodigy who was coached by pioneers of traditional Chinese paintings, to one of China's most acclaimed contemporary ink painters.Wang has came a long way with his unique take on traditional cultural legacies.
Wang Mingming 把自己的绘画艺术同当代文化相联系，从现代社会相协调，努力地实现创造性转化、创新性发展的一种成功的艺术探索。所谓心智通篇，就是艺术家的心灵要通他表现的审美对象天自然融为一体，这叫万有相通，天人合一。在我看来，王明明的画就达到了这种境界。
我喜欢他对于秋天的一种态度，他认为这个秋天是盛春潮嘛。开始呢，我把这个秋天画的树很高，就大一些，可是最后呢，我觉得只要我画到树梢表现的秋意，把它的空白拉大，空间更多，这个鹤的那种自由度更高，才能更表现我的一种对于这个中国画这个画面的空白的这种追求。床前明月光，疑是地上霜，举头望明月，低头思故乡，这个是大家非常熟悉的。我在画这套册页的时候，牵扯到很多夜景，可是如何去表现？有可能把背后给它涂成淡墨，也可以表现夜景。凡是有月的，我基本上都留了大块的空白，就表现这个月和一点云，把它衬托出来。这个呢，就是我这重点要再把这黄河之水天上来这种气度画出来，和李白呼应他举杯这个情节画出来，黄河之水的这种落差，这个水就必须用大的笔墨把它的那个速度和力量给表现出来。中国画发展到今天，对于中国画的这个创新与继承的问题，我觉得是值得思考的一个问题。习总书记对于这个传统艺术的传统文化的这个传承讲得非常的精辟，它是战略上的一个整体思考，非常有战略意义的。中国画如何进入艺术高峰，思考这个问题，一个是学习传统，一个是面向传统如何去继承。我在接待几个欧洲的博物馆馆长的时候，我去请他看我们画院的齐白石，他们非常的欣赏，也是20世纪的大师画的山水画，他们看完了没有任何的表示。可是这个大师呢，是一个我们看的已经是非常传统了，可是他有西方的有些痕迹，并不是中国的。我从他们的眼神里头都看出来，他们在寻找的与他们风格和他们所体现的画家的不同的特殊性，齐白石就是一个代表。唯有源头活水来， 中国画特有的东西，那我们必须给它保留和强化它。
我一直在寻找什么是中国精神呢？什么是中国的意境？
我有一个体会，在寻找中国意境、中国境界和中国精神的时候，只有我们中国从老祖宗那个，从一脉相承的里边去寻找这些大道，去提取中间的营养和基因，这才是我们最后能掐出来的形而上精神的东西。中华传统文化的源头活水，我特别的欣慰的是，最近这些年我去看很多的古代经典的这个博物馆的时候，年轻人非常多，他们是哎，觉得这个东西好看得懂，去吸收，这个就预示着，就是说我们传统绘画的这种生命力。做一个中国画家，有灵性，修养好，人品好，画风正，这个很重要。对社会你产生什么样的效应，社会责任在哪，对文化建设你要起什么样的作用，这个是非常重要的，需要很多独立思考的东西，是心胸问题，眼界问题，要画到那个高度才能留住。没有产生有说服力的作品，一切我觉得都是苍白的。21世纪中，中国画家处在一个条件非常优越这个时代，从单纯的笔墨追求中走出来，融入这个时代，去研究传统，去体悟传统，从我们的是吧这优秀的传统文化中找这样的答案，以自己的擅长为基础去实践，才能找出来我们中国特有的艺术之魂。